everybody, this is Kazan with Spellbinders Paper Arts. Today's project is a vintage inspired banner that I made for a bridal shower. And I used some of Spellbinders' older die templates as well as the brand new ones that were recently released at this past CHA held in Anaheim, California 2012. So let's get started because I'm really excited to show you some of the new intricate die templates that's going to give your projects a really beautiful vintage shabby chic look. So to create my bridal shower banner, I followed a few simple steps. I started off by building the base of the banner using Spellbinders Nested Lacy Pennants. The code for this is S5029. As well as Spellbinders Nested Pennants, and this code is S5028. And I cut 5 shapes of the lacy nested pennants and 5 of the nested pennants. And then I just layered them on top of one another like this. And this beautiful paper is from My Mind's Eye. It's their Follow Your Heart collection. Then I went ahead and cut out these beautiful, very intricate die template shapes, and this is all from Spellbinders Persian Motif die template set, and this code is S5079. And the set actually includes 3 different shapes that I used on my project. So the one is the motif's 12 point, then there's a 6 points and a 4 points, so you can use all of these designs from one set on your project if you want. Then I cut out the most beautiful intricate design frame like that, and this is Spellbinders brand new floral ovals, and I used Spellbinders classic ovals to cut out the shape in the middle to create this antique looking frame. I think this is my absolute favorite die template at the moment. And I'm going to show you how I went ahead and made this. So I started off with a piece of white cardstock like this, and I used Spellbinders Classic Ovals Large to cut out the shape in the middle. Then I took the frame, the oval, from the floral ovals, and I'm going to position that over like that and cut it out. I have a little insider tip for you though. This little design tip is going to save you so much time, and it's really simple and easy to use. Because these lines are so intricate, and it depends on the kind of cardstock that you use or kind of paper that you use, it might be a little bit difficult to remove the paper or cardstock from the die template. So what we do here at Spellbinders is we sometimes take advantage of plain wax paper from your kitchen drawer. And all you do is, when you're layering it, you place the wax paper between your die template and your cardstock like that. So now I have my cardstock first, and I have my wax paper, and then I have my die template, which is with a cut side down. And I'm going to run this through my grand caliper, just like that. And then when you take it out, once it's cut, it's going to come out really easy, and you're simply going to remove the sheet of wax paper like that. And that's really cute. I still have to figure out what I'm going to make with my wax paper cutouts. But for now, I'm just going to be using the beautiful intricate design from my floral ovals. And then it's a matter of simply building each little pennant like this with different elements that you like to use, different embellishments, buttons, cardstock alpha stickers, and that's what I've done over here. Thanks so much for joining me today. Have fun making those vintage inspired projects. See you soon.